Today, let's discuss the rural development programs. So what are these community development programs, intensive agriculture district programs, and drought-prone area programs? About the community development programs, these programs were launched in India on 2nd October in 1952. There were 55 community development projects. And each project had an operational area of about 400 to 500 square mile. They comprised around 300 villages and a population of about 2 lakhs. The project area was divided into three development blocks, each consisting of about 100 villages and a population of 60 to 70,000. The project was headed by a project officer and a number of subject matter extension officers in the discipline of agriculture, animal husbandry, cooperation, industries, different industries, rural engineering, social education, etc. So each project had about 60 multi-purposes. Village level workers, VLWs, one of each group of 5 to 10 villages. They were government appointed extension functionaries at the lowest level who were nearest to the people. The multi-purpose VLWs were common to the development engaged in the rural work. And the people in all the project area responded enthusiastically and the need for a rapid expansion. The need for the program to other parts of the country was urgently felt. Limited resources, however, did not permit the rapid extension. Around the year 1953, the National Extension Service, NSE program was launched with the idea of having wider coverage at less cost and more people's participation. Each NES block had about 100 villages and about 65,000 populations. The NES block was headed by a block development officer or BDO and had a number of extension officers. For the NES blocks, funds were drastically reduced and the number of multipurpose or VLWs were brought down to 10. So from 60 it was down to 10. NES was thorough. It was thrown off as the agency and CD as the method to bring about the socio-economic transformation of the rural people. The momentum gained by the NES program was intensified by converting some selected NES blocks to community development blocks. The program was initiated in 1954. The NES blocks were produced good. They produced good results, and the people participation was in a good quantity. So these blocks funds were again increased, and they were again provided with additional staff and support. So what are the concepts of community development? The term community development appears to have originated from Cambridge in England. It was the year 1948, the Cambridge Summer Conference on African Administration recommended this term, defining it as a movement designed to promote better living for the whole community with the active participation, if possible, on the initiative of the community. But if this initiative is not forthcoming spontaneously, by the use of techniques of arousing and stimulating in order to secure its action and enthusiastic response to the movement. Basically, koshish ye ki gayi thi ki sab jane jo hain wo iske andar part le. The UN in 1956 defined community development as the process by which the effort of the national themselves, of the people themselves, are united with those of government authorities to improve the economic, social and cultural conditions of the communities, to integrate these communities into the life of the nation and to enable them to contribute fully to the national progress. The idea was ki sab jane ek saath part le, government bhi part le aur jo janta hai wo bhi part le. The International Cooperation Administration of 1957 in its guidelines stated that community development is a process of social action in which the people of a community organize themselves for planning and action, define their common and individual needs and problems, make group and individual plans to meet their needs and solve their problems, execute these plans with a minimum of reliance upon community resources, and supplement these resources with when necessary with service and materials from government and non-governmental agencies outside the community. Tyler and others in 1965 conceived community development as a method by which people who live in local villages or communities are involved in helping to improve their own economics and social conditions and thereby become effective working group in programs of national development. The adoption of this method is based upon a knowledge that villages who in past have seemed to be lethargic and not interested in change will become dynamic if they are permitted to take decisions concerning exercise, responsibility for, and are helped to carry out projects and programs for improvement in their own villages. CDs have also been defined as balanced programs for stimulating the local potential for growth in every direction. It promises, the main idea is to promise reciprocal advance in both wealth and welfare, not on the basis of outside charity, but by building on the latent vitality of the beneficiaries themselves. The idea is to reduce the intake of outside aid. In 1967, Mukherjee, he summed up these concepts and he stated that community development is a process of changing from the traditional way of living of rural communities to progressive way of living, to try to go and modernize themselves as a method by which people can be assisted to develop themselves on their own capacity and resources. As a progress of accomplishing certain activities in fields concerning the welfare of the rural people, and as a movement for progress with a certain ideological content. So what are the objectives of the community development programs in India? The community, these were objectives were outlined by the Planning Commission in the first three five-year plan. These were essential for the improvement of all phases of the village life. The Ministry of Community Development and Cooperation, Government of India 1962 stated the specific objectives, which were as follows. The basic idea was to assist the villagers in having effective panchayats, cooperatives and schools. And through these village institutions, plan and carry out integrated multi-phase family village block and district plans. And these were conducted for increasing agriculture production, improving existing village crafts and industries, and organizing new ones, providing minimum essential health services and improving health practices, providing recreational facilities and programs, improving housing and family living condition, and finally, providing programs for village women and youth. What are the basic assumptions in community development? Ross in 1967 made some basic assumptions in community organization, which appear to hold good for community development as well. They are communities of people can develop capacity to deal with their own problem. People want change and can change. People should participate in making, adjusting or controlling the major changes taking place in their community. Change in community living that are self-imposed or self-developed have a meaning and permanence that imposed changes do not have. A holistic approach can deal successfully with problem with which a fragmented approach cannot cope. Democracy requires cooperative participation and action in the affair of the community, and that people must learn the skills which make this possible. Frequently, communities of people need help in organizing to deal with their needs, just as many individuals require help in coping with their individual problems. What are the guiding principles of community development? There was a report of the UN Economic and Social Council. The guiding principle of community development summarized as following. In this, activities undertaken must correspond to the basic needs of community. The first project should be initiated in response to the excess needs of the people. Full and balanced community development requires concerted action and establishment of multi-purpose programs. Change attitude in people are as important as the material achievement of community projects during the initial stage of development. Changing attitude in people are as important as material achievement of community during the development. Community development aims at increasing and better participation of people in community affairs, revitalization of existing form of local government, and transition towards effective local administration where it is not yet functioning. The identification, encouragement, and training of local leadership should be a basic objective of any program. Greater reliance on the participation of women and youth in community projects InvitRate's development program establishes them on a wide basis and secures long-range expansion. To be fully effective, self-help projects for communities require both intensive and extensive assistance by the government. Implementation of community development program on a national scale requires adoption of consistent policies, specific administrative arrangements, recruitment and training of personal, mobilization of local and national resources, and organization of research, experimentation and evaluation. The resource of voluntary and non-governmental organizations should be fully utilized in community development program as the local, national and international level. Economic and social progresses at this local level necessitate parallel development on a wider national scale. What are the activities of these? The following activities are undertaken. These include your agriculture and related things. These include your reclamation of available virgin and wasteland, providing water, development of electricity, commercial fertilizers, quality seeds. There should be provision for all these things. There should be promotion of agricultural techniques and land utilization. There should be veterinary aid available to the farmers. Technical information, materials and bulletin should be available for the farmers. So these things were included into the CD program's activities. Then further you had your provision for improved agriculture implements. There should be credit facilities, animal husbandries and breeding centers should be there. Facilities and development of inland fisheries. There should be promotion of home economics, development of fruit and vegetable cultivation, provision of soil survey and information. So all these things, they come under the activities of community development program. These came under agricultural and related matter. Then you have your communications, which are including provisions for road, encouragement for mechanical road transport services, development of animal transport facilities, education, provision for free education, preferably your basic education at elementary stage. And then you had provision for high and middle school, library services, healthcare, disease control, drinking water supply improvement, medical aid. So all these things, they come under your activities of community development. Furthermore, they also had training. Trainings were done under refresher courses to improve the existing standards. There were involvement of agriculturists, training of agriculturists, extension assistants, artisans. There were training for supervisors, social welfare was there, organization of community entertainment was there, audiovisual aids for instructing, sports facilities. So these things were included. Furthermore, supplementary employment was also encouraged. Cottage industry hai, apna craft hai, ye sari cheeze subsidiary occupation ke andar aati hai. Encouragement tha medium and small scale industries ka, MSSIs ka employment surplus karna hai, isliye local needs ko fulfill karna hai, export karna hai material. So encourage isme bhi kiya jata tha ki trade aap kar sako, auxiliary services hai, welfare services hai, uske andar aap participate karo, bricks ka aap construction kar sakte ho, sawmills ka kar sakte ho. So in sab tarikon se inhone help kiya. Phir housing ho jati hai, housing ke andar aapka demonstration ho gaya, training ho gayi, kis tarike se aap demonstrate karte ho cheezon ko, improve karte ho techniques ko housing ki. So ye sari cheeze jo hai ye aapki जो कम्युनिटी डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम है वो इनको इस तरीके से पार्ट करता है. IADP is popularly known as package program and was launched in the country in 1960. On a pilot basis in 7 selected districts, the central idea behind IADP was to increase the agricultural productivity, and this increase was presumed that it will lead to economic growth, which will bring welfare to the society. The program aims at combining technical know-how, credit and production supplies for stepping up agricultural production. The method adopted in IADP was to demonstrate the feasibility of increased agricultural production rapidly by concentrating all factors of production at the same time in an integrated action program in selected areas fulfilling optimum conditions. Agriculture, like all other industry, needs high degree of investment before it can be self-generating and self-financing. There was a deviation from the multi-purpose approach in community development to single purpose approach in increasing agricultural production through IATP. There are certain preparatory stages, and these consist of the following. There is a selection of the district which has assured supply of water and no exposed to which is not exposed to hazardous natural materials. It should be well developed, and there should be some sort of well developed cooperative credit structure, and it should have maximum potential to show increased production within a short possible time. Should be strengthening of the cooperative institutions, then creating general awareness among the people, selection, appointment and posting of the staff, training of the staff, then there is organizational resources benchmark survey, and then assisting the needs for supplies. There is also construction, and maybe if there is no construction possibility, then you can go for hiring of the godowns, strengthening of the transport arrangements, establishing the agricultural implement workshops. For example, you have your seed and soil testing laboratories, and then there should be implementation of local works programming having a direct bearing to the production increase. Implementation of the program is to be done in a phased way, which is understood. In the first year, 20%, and by the end of 5 years, 65% area is to be covered. This is the Panchvarshiya Yojana program. The program is to be implemented slowly, taking into consideration whether people have understood the basic philosophy. The essential features of these stages include presentation of individual farms and village production plan, simple plan for majority and more comprehensive plans for few progressive cultivators, adequate and timely supply of credits and input based on production plans. You have your organizing cooperative marketing societies, and strengthening of the transportation and analysis and evaluation of the program. The distinctive features are as follows. There are two factors of production known less. So what happened is that all these factors, they were not provided simultaneously. And since they were not provided simultaneously, it was not provided timely and adequately. So initial inputs like fertilizers, they were to be made available 100% of the requirement. And previous credit which was available, it was given only to the credit farmers. In the new program, farmers who joined the program with some production plan, they had the potential to get some credit. In selected areas, more agricultural and cooperative staff will be posted. This was one of the possibilities. And composite demonstration instead of single factor demonstration, economics of demonstrations will be worked out. And periodical training of staff and analysis and evaluation was to be done. These were the distinctive features of the program. With reference to shortcoming, educational approach to reach the cultivators was lacking. Emphasis was anyhow to make the cultivators join the program. Training program of staff was not clear. In many cases, these were found below standards and were not, they were not able to impress the farmers. Staff were not clear about the methods to reach the cultivators. Posting of the staff was not adequately and timely. Furthermore, workshop, seed testing and soil testing laboratories were not functioning. There was an issue with transportation and land development programs, as these were not progressing satisfactorily. Then cultivators were not using insecticides. So, Because they were not using insecticides, there were issues with the crops. There was a problem with communication, cooperatives were not functioning well. There was a lack of action research and very little participation of women was there in these programs. So these were the shortcomings. Similarly, you had your drought prone areas program, DPAP. And these were Swaram Jayanti program. So Swarozgar Yojana, SGSY, drought prone area program was established. It was initiated in 1970-71 as a non-central sector scheme. 74 districts were identified which were drought prone and they were grouped under 54 units. The program's aim was to mitigate the severity and the scarcity of the water. Yeah, it was also the aim to execute rural works in order to generate employment. The program sought to be reoriented on the basis of an area development approach and was redesigned as a drought-prone area program. At the time, the midterm appraisal was there in the fifth year plan. This program was confined to those areas which were originally kept taken up under the rural work programs. Basic objectives included reducing the severity and the impact of drought, stabilizing the income of people, particularly weaker sections of the society, and restoring the ecological balance. And during the fourth plan, this was a central scheme with 100% financial assistance from the center. From the fifth plan onward, this scheme has been operating with funds being shared between center and the state, and the ratio was 50-50. Under the new strategy of rural development, which was adopted in the sixth plan, this program was merged with IRDP, Integrated Rural Development Program. Now, if you consider the innovativeness and utility of this program, the World Bank provided nearly $35 million under the agreement, right? And this amount was given for six projects in the states of Rajasthan, Maharashtra, AP, and Karnataka. The interdisciplinary task force was also set up by the Government of India. This was done in June 1980. And their aim was to review the scope and coverage of the program. This task force submitted the report on July, in the month of July 1982, after 2 years. The report stressed the importance of interlinkages between various rural development programs and made many useful recommendations to enhance the effectiveness of these programs. This continued during the eighth plan and is likely to continue in the ninth and the coming plans also. In the year 1996-97, the program was in operation in 947 blocks. There were 153 districts and 13 states which were involved there. The expenditure of rupees nearly 1,742 crores was incurred under the program since its inception in 1973-74, and this data is till the year of 95. Near 57-58 lakh hectare of land was covered under the three core activities of land development, water resource development, and afforestation over the same period of time. So the NREGA Act was enacted in September 2005 and was brought into force with effect from February 2006 in 200 most backward districts of the country. The objectives was to provide 100 days of guaranteed unskilled wages employment to each rural household opting for it. Now, the NREGA, this marks as a paradigm shift and stands out among the plethora of wage employment programs as it bestows a legal right and guarantee to the rural population through an act of parliament and is not a scheme unlike the other wages employment programs. It covers all the districts of the country within the ambit of it, and the focus of the act is on work relating to water conservation, drought proofing, this includes your afforestation and tree plantation, land development, flood control, protection, this includes your drainage in waterlogged areas and rural connectivity, in terms of all weather roads. Each district has to prepare a prospective plan of 5 years with a bottom-up approach deriving from the needs of the local community. The said plan should have the approval of the community and the PRIs. Whole idea is that this has a bottom-up approach and the people involved in it includes those who are underprivileged individuals. Now, how are you going to implement it? So, panchayats have a key role in planning and implementation and monitoring of the act through preparation of prospective plans, approval of projects, execution of work at least to the extent of 50% in terms of cost. What's happening here is, so panchayat hai, uska jo role hai, wo ye hai ki usko ye plans प्रूव करने हैं, उनको एग्जीक्यूट कराना है और उस हद तक एग्जीक्यूट कराना है कम से कम जो कॉस्ट है उसकी 50% तक वो यूटिलाइज करें. द एक्ट एनसेजेस स्ट्रिक्ट विजिलेंस एंड मॉनिटरिंग एंड द ग्राम सभा हैज द पावर ऑफ सोशल ऑडिट. लोकल विजिलेंस एंड मॉनिटरिंग कमिटीज, दीज आर टू बी सेटअप एंड द पर्पस ऑफ देम इज टू इंश्योर द क्वालिटी ऑफ द वर्क. अब प्रोविजन है रिप्रेजेंटेशन का इन कम्युनिटीज़ के अंदर, एस सी एस टीज़ के लिए एंड वुमेन के लिए भी है. सो एंड एक ये चीज़ है कि एटलीस्ट इसमें रूल है कि 1/3 ऑफ द बेनिफिशियरीज शुड बी वुमेन. यू हैव योर की रिकॉर्ड सच एज मस्टर ऑयल, एसेट रजिस्ट्रेशन एंड एम्प्लॉयमेंट रजिस्टर्स, दीज आर टू बी मेंटेन एंड इनका जो पब्लिक एक्सेस है दैट हैज़ टू बी इंश्योर्ड. The Act, it also envisages a grievance redressal mechanism and helpline. इसके अंदर grievance redressal का भी mechanism है और इसके लिए grievance redressal की एक helpline भी है. Comprehensive MIS has been developed to capture work-wise and household-wise data and track the process of resources invested. संपूर्ण ग्रामीण रोजगार योजना, इट वॉज अनाउंसमेंट वॉज मेड बाई द ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर इन 2001 एंड वॉज नेम्ड एज संपूर्ण ग्रामीण रोजगार योजना और एस जी आर वाई एंड इट वॉज लॉन्च्ड ऑन 25th ऑफ सेप्टेम्बर ऑफ 2001. वॉट दे डिड वॉज दे मर्ज द टू स्कीम्स, ई एस एल JGSY. The objective of the program is to provide additional wage employment in the rural areas as also food security alongside the creation of durable community, social and economic infrastructure in the rural areas. The program is self-targeting in nature with special emphasis to provide wage employment to women, scheduled caste, scheduled tribes and parents of children withdrawn from hazardous occupation. The strategy was divided into two parts, two streams. The first stream of the program is implemented at district and intermediary level, panchayats, and 50% of the funds available under the SGRY are earmarked for first stream. These are distributed between the Zilla Parishad and the intermediate panchayat in the ratio of 40 to 60. The second stream of the program will be implemented at the village panchayat level. 50% of the remaining SGRY funds are earmarked for this stream. The entire funds are released to the village panchayats through DRDAs or Jilla Parishads. So what are the salient features of SGRY? The salient features includes that it is a centrally sponsored scheme, CSS, which is being implemented with a total outlay of rupees nearly 10,000 crore. Under the scheme, 50 lakh tons of food grain amounting for nearly 5,000 crores is provided every year free of cost to the state government and union territory administrations. The remaining fund of rupees 5,000 crore is utilized to meet the cost components of wages and material cost. The cost of cash component of the program is shared by the center and state in the ratio of 75-25. The payment of food grain is made by Ministry of Rural Development to the Food Corporation of India directly. About 100 crore mandals of employment are envisaged to be generated every year in the rural areas through this SGRY. 50% of the total available fund under the SGRY are provided to each stream. Every worker seeking employment under this scheme are provided 5 kilograms of food grains in kind. This is per mandal as part of the wages. Balance of wages are paid in cash so that they are assured of the notified minimum wages. The state government and union territory administrations are free to calculate the cost of food grains at either BPL rate or APL rates, or anywhere in between these two rates. The SGRY has been in operation since 2002-2003. Since the scheme was launched in the middle of 2002, the ongoing scheme of the EAS and JGSY were merged. This program permits work which leads to the creation of additional wage employment, durable assets and infrastructure, particularly those which assist in drought-proofing, such as soil and moisture conservation work, watershed development, promotion of traditional water resources, afforestation and construction of rural infrastructure and link roads, primary school buildings, dispensaries, veterinary hospitals, marketing infrastructures and panchayat ghars in rural areas. How are these monitored? They are monitored. The overall supervision of the program rests with the Zilla Parishad. The program will be regularly monitored by the Department of Rural Development in accordance with the inbuilt monitoring mechanisms, including periodical reports and returns. Vigilance and monitoring committee visits by officers of the central and state government. There are also visits by area officers of the Ministry of Rural Development. The program would also be evaluated through studies conducted by reputed institutions, organizations, and sponsored by central or state governments. These programs are usually top down from the local or regional authorities, regional development agencies, NGOs, national government or international development organizations. But then local population can also bring about indigenous initiatives for development. The term is not limited to the issues for developing countries. In fact, many of the developed countries have very active rural development programs. The main aim of the rural development policy is to develop the underdeveloped villages. To develop a country, not only industrialization is sufficient, but also the very common man has to survive. Rural development is defined as improving the living standards of masses of low-income population residing in rural areas. According to World Bank, rural development is a strategy designed
to improve the economic and social life of a specific group of people by extending the benefits of development to the poorest among those who seek livelihood in the rural area. According to Finance Ministry, the rural development is systematic and integrated use of national resources, enabling every person to engage himself in production or social useful occupation and earn income that will meet at least basic needs. According to the National Commission on Agriculture, rural development means development of an area and the people through optimum development and utilization of local resources by bringing about necessary institutions, structures, and attitudinal changes, and by delivering packages of services to improve all fields of the rural, poor, and rural weak. The term rural development is a subset of a broader development. However, we define it, development is an universally cherished goal of individuals, families, communities, and nations all over the world. Development is also natural in the sense that all forms of life on planet Earth have an inherent urge to survive and develop. Given these two attributes, that is, its universal supremacy as a goal and its natural occurrence, development deserves a scientific study and analysis. Hence, it is not surprising that the subject of development has been studied by scholars of all faith, ideologies, and discipline. Connotations of rural development. The term rural development connotes overall development of rural areas with a view to improve the quality of life of rural people. In this sense, it is a comprehensive and multidimensional concept and encompasses the development of agricultural and allied activities, village and cottage industries and crafts, socio-economic infrastructure, community service and facilities, and above all, the human resource in rural area. As a phenomenon, rural development is the end result of interactions between various physical, technological, economic, socio-cultural, and institutional factors. As a strategy, it is designed to improve the economic and social well-being of a specific group of people, the rural people. As a discipline, it is multidisciplinary in nature, representing an intersection of agricultural, social, behavioral, engineering, and management science. Rural development is a strategy to enable a specific group of people, poor rural women and men, gain for themselves and their children more of what they want and need. It involves helping the poorest among those who seek a livelihood in the rural areas to demand and control more of the benefits of rural development. The group includes small-scale farmers, tenants, and the landless. Thus, the term may be used to imply any one of the above mentioned connotations. To avoid ineffective floundering among the myriad definitions, defining rural development as a process leading to sustainable improvement in the quality of life of rural people, especially the poor, can be true. basic elements of rural development, whether whatever the geographic location, culture, and historical stage of development of a society, there are at least three basic elements which are considered to constitute the true meaning of rural development: basic necessities of life, self-respect, and freedom. People have certain basic needs without which it would be impossible or very difficult for them to survive. The basic necessities include food, clothes, shelter, basic literacy, primary health care, and security of life and property. When any one or all of them are absent in or in critically short supply, we may state that a condition of absolute underdevelopment exists. Provision of the basic necessities of life to everyone. When anyone or all of them are absent or in critically short supply, we may state that a condition of absolute underdevelopment exists. Provision of the basic necessities of life to everybody is the primary responsibility of all economics, whether they are capitalist, socialist, or mixed. In this sense, we may claim that economic growth, increased per capita availability of basic necessities, is a necessary condition for improvement of the quality of life of rural people, which is rural development. Self-respect, which every person has and every nation seeks, some sort of self-respect, dignity, or honor. Absent or denial of self-respect indicates lack of development. Freedom is context refers to political or ideological freedom, economic freedom, and freedom from social servitude. As long as a society is bound by the servitude of men to nature, ignorance, other men, institution, and dogmatic belief, it cannot claim to have achieved the goal of development. Servitude in any form reflects a state of underdevelopment. The development of rural areas in India is a multidimensional problem which has been so far viewed by the policymakers and academicians mainly from the economic aspect only. In India, rural development is not only an economic problem but also a more social problem. Michael Pitodaro views rural development as most suitable in Indian context in following manners: improvement in the level of living standards, including employment, education, health, nutrition, housing, and a variety of social services; decreasing inequity in distribution of rural incomes and in the rural-urban imbalances in incomes and economic opportunities; to sustain capacity of rural sectors. In terms, it seems that in Indian context, rural development is a mere sociological problem rather than an economic problem. With the process of economic development and growing awareness, the social system in the country is becoming more complicated and unfavorable to economic condition. The caste system continues to be strong moral phenomenon of social structure in India, which undoubtedly is an ordering system in marriage, basis of communal participation, a social control agency, and a political instrument, affecting the rural development process adversely. So The policies of rural development may so designed to crack down the prevalent social structure in the country.
Rural development programs and policies which are followed in India after independence reveals four strategies of development. First, growth-oriented strategy. This is based on philosophy that rural people, like any other people, are rational decision makers who, when given adequate opportunity and a proper environment, will try to maximize their income. And role of the state in this strategy is to build infrastructure and maintain a favorable climate to stimulate the growth of rural enterprises. The critical assumption of this strategy is that the benefits of increased production will gradually trickle down to the poor. ऊपर से नीचे तक जो फाइनेंसेस हैं वो ट्रांसफर होते हैं रईस से गरीब तक. द रेगुलेशन एंड कोऑर्डिनेशन ऑफ द एक्टिविटीज ऑफ प्राइवेट एंड पब्लिक एजेंसीज इज प्राइमरली थ्रू मार्केट मैकेनिज्म. जो रेगुलेशंस हैं कोऑर्डिनेशंस हैं जितनी भी प्राइवेट और पब्लिक एजेंसीज के वो मार्केट मैकेनिज्म्स के थ्रू कोऑर्डिनेट होते हैं. दिस पैराडिग्म फॉर्म्ड द बेसिस ऑफ द प्रेडोमिनेंट एग्रीकल्चरल डेवलपमेंट स्ट्रेटजी ऑफ द 1960s. व्हेन प्रोग्राम्स लाइक द इंटेंसिव एग्रीकल्चर डिस्ट्रिक्ट प्रोग्राम IADP, the Intensive Cattle Development Program, CIDP, the High Yielding Variety Program, HYVP, they were launched. But this paradigm failed to make any dent on the basic problems of poverty, unemployment, and inequality, and had to be abandoned. Welfare oriented strategy. This seeks to promote the well-being of the rural population in general and the rural poor in particular through large scale social programs like the minimum needs program, applied nutrition program, midday meal program, etc. The primary means used in this strategy are free provisions, distribution of goods, service, and civic amenities in rural areas. The critical assumption of this strategy are that people are not competent to identify and resolve their problems, and that government specialists can identify their needs and meet them with the financial and administrative resource available with the government. The role of villagers is that of passive receptor of service. This strategy has paternalistic orientation. The performance of the program is judged by the oriented programs presented in a mixed picture. The rural poor have benefited significantly through some programs in a few areas, but not in others. There are two major criticisms of this strategy. Namely, it has created dependence and it requires resources that are beyond the means of governments. Responsive strategy. This is aimed at helping rural people help themselves through their own organizations and other support systems. Its concern is with responding to the felt needs of the rural people. As defined by them, the role of the government is to facilitate the self-help efforts of villagers by providing technologies and resources that are not locally available. गवर्नमेंट का रोल क्या होता है? गवर्नमेंट का रोल है सेल्फ हेल्प एफर्ट वाले जो विलेजर्स हैं उनको प्रोवाइड करना है टेक्नोलॉजीज और रिसोर्सेज को. कौन सी टेक्नोलॉजीज और रिसोर्स? जो कि लोकली अवेलेबल नहीं. द क्रिटिकल अजम्पशन ऑफ दिस स्ट्रेटजी इज दैट द रूरल पुअर विल आइडेंटिफाई एंड रिजॉल्व देयर प्रॉब्लम्स इफ प्रोवाइडेड विद मिनिमल सपोर्ट एंड अदरवाइज लेफ्ट टू देयर ओन डिवाइस एंड इनिशिएटिव्स. क्या अजम्पशन है इस स्ट्रेटजी का? कि जो रूरल गरीब हैं उनको वो अपनी प्रॉब्लम्स रिजॉल्व कर लेंगे अगर उनको मिनिमम सपोर्ट अगर मिल जाता है तो. कम्युनिटी पार्टिसिपेशन इन एंड इन कंट्रोल पीएफ प्रोजेक्ट एक्टिविटीज इज द प्राइमरी परफॉर्मेंस इंडिकेटर ऑफ दिस स्ट्रेटजी. कितनी कम्युनिटी पार्ट करती है, कितना पीएफ जनरेट होता है, प्रोजेक्ट एक्टिविटीज क्या क्या हो रही हैं, ये सारी जो चीज़ें हैं ये परफॉर्मेंस इंडिकेटर्स होते हैं इस रिस्पॉन्सिव स्ट्रैटेजी में. इंडियाज ऑपरेशन फ्लड विच वॉज लॉन्च इन 1970 इन द 18 मिल्क शेड्स इन 10 स्टेट इज अ गुड एग्जाम्पल ऑफ दिस स्ट्रैटेजी. जो अमूल का ऑपरेशन फ्लड है, मतलब अमूल का ऑपरेशन फ्लड नहीं, ऑपरेशन फ्लड से जो एसोसिएटेड अमूल है, ये एक बहुत बढ़िया एग्जाम्पल है इस टाइप की स्ट्रैटेजी का. Operation Flood aimed at modernizing and developing India's dairy industry through a three-tier structure. Anand Pattern Dairy Cooperatives. Many voluntary agencies are also following this paradigm of development. Integrated or holistic strategy. This combines all the positive features of the earlier three strategies and is designed to simultaneously achieve the goals of growth, welfare, equity, and community participation. ये जो है ये सब चीजें combine करके बनी है strategy. इसमें सारे positive features ले लिए हैं पिछली तीन strategies की. और ये जो डिज़ाइन है इसका डिज़ाइन का पर्पस ये है कि ये सारे जो गोल्स हैं ग्रोथ से एसोसिएटेड, वेलफेयर से एसोसिएटेड, इक्विटी से एसोसिएटेड, कम्युनिटी के पार्टिसिपेशन से एसोसिएटेड, उन सबको ये साइमल्टेनियसली अचीव करती है. दिस पैराडिज्म टेक्स अ वेरी कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव बट इंटीग्रेटेड व्यू ऑफ द बेसिक प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ पॉवर्टी. ये जो तरीका है ये बहुत ही इंडिकेटेड व्यू रखती है जो पॉवर्टी से एसोसिएटेड जो प्रॉब्लम्स होती हैं और जो अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट से होती हैं और इनइक्वालिटी से होती हैं, उन सब को ये अपने व्यू के अंदर रखती हैं. एंड सीक्स टू एड्रेस द फिजिकल, इकोनॉमिक, टेक्नोलॉजिकल, सोशल, मोटिवेशनल, ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल एंड पॉलिटिकल बेसिस ऑफ दीज प्रॉब्लम. और क्या कोशिश करती है ये? कोशिश ये रहती है कि ये जो प्रॉब्लम्स हैं इन प्रॉब्लम्स को हम फिजिकल, इकोनॉमिकल, टेक्नोलॉजिकल, सोशल, मोटिवेशनल, ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल एंड पॉलिटिकल बेसिस से ख़त्म कर सकते हैं. द मल्टीपल गोल्स ऑफ द स्ट्रेटजी आर सॉट टू बी अचीव्ड बाय बिल्डिंग द कैपेसिटी ऑफ द कम्युनिटी टू इन्वॉल्व इटसेल्फ in development in partnership with the government. The critical assumptions underlying this approach is that the government can restructure societal powers, relationships, and centralized bureaucracies can learn to share power with community groups. Successful implementation for vertical and lateral integration, a combination of specialist and generalist skills, institutional leadership, social intervention, capability, and systems management. But this strategy requires complex decentralized matrix structure with permanent mechanisms.